no woman is an island. Nor would we want to be. Because if you can't share real life, the real you, in real time, how boring would this world be? So, take a hand, lend a hand, and raise your hand. And let's do life together.
Together. Together.
Good evening and welcome to the Listening Room Cafe. As a friendly reminder, we have a $15 food and beverage minimum per person for all of our shows. So please take a look at our menu and enjoy one of our specialties. As the artists take the stage, please be reminded we are called the Listening Room for a reason. We ask that table conversation be kept to a whisper and a minimum in order to allow all of our guests to enjoy the experience of Nashville's best songwriters. Please feel free to utilize our outside patio for further conversations, weather permitting. Enjoy your evening and thanks again for choosing the Listening Room Cafe.
Songs of Suffragettes is a community of dreamers, go-getters, and trailblazing women
who embrace their own and each other's voices.
It has formed a sisterhood of theaters, singer-songwriters,
who bring diverse voices and unique perspectives to the dance.
There's always an amazing crowd, and it was my first show that I ever played in Nashville.
And when it comes to country music, I think that women are just as good as men.
Songs of Suffragettes spotlights the women.
Women.
Country music.
Who believe that supporting each other is more important than competition.
We're just hoping to spread a little bit of love, laughter, and sass in the world.
The first one that I'm missing. You got me second guessing.
making my debut. It's on Suffragettes at the Listening Room. I have my first show back from quarantine, and I'm just so excited to be up here in front of you guys with all of these amazing girls. I think something Kaylee said earlier about how we're all up here because we want our voices to be heard. You guys are here because you want our voices to be heard. I think I got a double whammy in life. I got the woman thing, but I also got this crazy curly hair. So, you know, I thought it would be fitting for me if I would also on the stage uplift some of my other fellow black artists. So tonight I'm going to be playing songs that I've written myself and with other co-writers of color. So I'm very excited for that. Yes. So this first one I'm going to be doing is a song called Wine and Love. I wrote it with my dear friend Simon White, so I hope you guys like it.
No, Okay, hi. Anyways, how are you guys doing? So this song. Back in September, I released my first ever full-length album, and it's called Open Book.
Thank you.
And so many of the songs hit differently after, you know, I wrote the song about the worst, most complicated, craziest year of my life, and I was like, 2020 is going to be amazing. I literally rang in 2020 playing, I played at Nashville Leaders, so I opened up for Keith Urban and Jason Isbell, and I rang in 2020 on stage, cheersing champagne between Nicole Kidman and Steve Nicks. And I was like, this is gonna be the best freaking year of my life. And I was like, that was the best moment of my life. And then we were like, but that was midnight. And then after that, it's just been, anyways.
Was it technically still 2019?
I think. Wow. So anyways, but so I wrote this song. It's the kind of title track on the album. I took a line from it. And it's just about when people ask you how you are, and they know you're kind of going through it, and you're like, well, how do you think, buddy? Basically, like, I went through the end of a 6-year relationship and lost my sister to a drug overdose, like, back to back. And it was very public. I felt like Nashville being such a small town, big city situation, everybody knew, you know, like 2 a.m, I was like wasted in Midtown. Someone would be like, hey, honey, like, I just want to see, like, how you're doing. And I'm like, oh, well, freaking awful, thanks for asking. So I'm going to say huge child right there. this is kind of like, you know, when you get those emails now, I don't know about you guys, but you get these emails, it's like, hey guys, hope this email finds you well during this crazy time. And I'm like, well, it doesn't. So, so this song kind of feels like the 2020 mood. It's called Too Much to Say.
Nothing works. Thanks for asking. Is it making you nervous? All this honesty. Oh, I'm so sorry if you're a little uncomfortable. But I'm more uncomfortable watching you shift in your seat. How do I look like I've been doing?
Thank you.
totally screwed you up.
No, we're good. We're there. This is how I've been writing on piano because it's in front of my laptop, so I didn't pick up a guitar for like 3 months. It's good. My fingers feel great. Thanks, Russ.
Wow, I'm funny a little bit.
Wow.
I'm cracking myself up. Okay.
You still got it.
I don't.
Ever. I've never had it. I'm just like completely awkward.
Lies.
Thank you. I really do. I literally have my thing written on because I couldn't decide what I'm saying in order. But my name is Libby. I am from Edmonton, Alberta, Canada. And I usually be like, is anyone from Canada? But no one's from Canada. Whoa. How did you make it across the border? Sneaky, sneaky. Whoa. Yeah, they're strict up there. I know people that got a fine. My friend's little brother thought it'd be a great idea to just go drive around. Very innocent. They weren't doing anything. They probably went to like McDonald's. And a cop pulled them over and their license, their like driver's license did not match. And they got $1,000 each fine because they didn't live in the same house and they weren't quarantining properly. I'm like, yo,
okay.
We're just gonna get some nuggets.
I think we're snakes.
Okay. But I've been releasing music, weirdly enough, through quarantine, and it's been interesting. I honestly went into it with zero expectations because the world's just kind of blowing up constantly. So anyways, yeah, this is a song that I released, I guess it'd be the top of May. I played it a couple times at Suffragettes. It's called Shimmy. Oh, I thought you fell. I'm not gonna wait. It's called Sharing You. That is mom tune. I'm so sorry. I just like, I
think if we ever get a break on this today. I was like, am I gonna remember how to play guitar? I'm never gonna like talk to people.
Yeah, that's
not like I ever knew, but
we're working on it every day. That was, I'm sorry, I'm just gonna go.
I'll let you move in my place. I'll let you use all my things. I took you home for the holidays. I'm
It's like one of those songs that wasn't true, and then, you know, hey, it wasn't 2020, but, you know, might as well have been. It happened. It was good. Yeah. It just made it a real life thing. It wasn't a real life thing, and then it really was. And I was like, oh, cool. That's how life goes.
I didn't mean to put it out to the universe. Okay, Mia, what you got for us, girl?
Got some tuning, but this one, I was kind of thinking for some weird reason during quarantine about high school and about like just my life like right now and like how different it was and how no one kind of really knew, like no one even knew I did music in high school, so that's like really weird to think about because now that's like my life. But yeah. This one's called Nobody Knew. Nobody Knew. Okay.
Nobody knew.
chills. That was amazing.
So good.
I'm just so obsessed with Mia and Antia because
yeah. Her name was Mia and Antia. B, she's just like the cutest little, most unsuspecting thing. And you're just like so bubbly, and then you drop a bomb like that.
Okay.
She did this on the YouTube live stream too, playing like a song that just hit me in the feels. And thankfully, like my camera was off, so but now it's not. You guys know. I've talked about the stage so many times, it's just gonna happen. I can feel it.
Cool. Well, this next song, I'm going to keep it a little low-key here, but this song has a really special place in my heart. It's called Lonely Does, and at the time, I didn't know that it did until us three kind of came back together. I wrote this with Allie Dunn and Lance Carpenter, and yeah, thank you. They're great. And we wrote it thinking it was a breakup song, came back together, and we were like, wow, this is actually a lot deeper than that. Then I thought about it more, and it actually totally represented something that happened in my life in high school. And so I won't get into that, but it's about losing somebody, breaking up with somebody, or it's about, you know, truly losing somebody, which is something we all go through and it sucks. And in that case, it really did affect me. So this song is called Lonely Does.
Thank you.
because in high school I looked a lot different. I used to straighten my hair like pin straight, and then I would curl it again.
Wait, like, I won't let this take you.
I mean hours. It took me 2 hours to straighten, then usually it's like 1 hour to curl. And usually like an hour to tangle a mess. And I paid like a lot of money to get my hair chemically straightened. Like it was a whole thing that I did for probably 8 or 10 years because I just, after you get a few, so many comments of being a liar or things, you're just like, I don't want this at all. And I look at myself now, and really it wasn't until I moved to Nashville actually that I saw people that just were amazing doing, being themselves and doing their own thing. And I was like, wait, why am I trying to be someone I'm not? Why am I trying to be like all of these Southern Belles when I'm a different type of Southern Belle, I guess, you know? And so this song, I wrote it back in January when I'm on the curly hair journey. And it's funny because the song has gone so many iterations and so many things have been happening in my life and in the world. But this is kind of a love song to my curls and my strength, I think, for growing up and learning to love myself. So this song is called Southern Curls.
And isn't she gorgeous?
I mean, look at this.
I know. Tell that to my wife. Well, my mom, she had no idea how to tame it. So we tried our best. We really tried our best. But thank God for TikTok and YouTube to give me the select here.
It is
dangerous. Watch out. But this is Southern Girls.
For a crowd of blue eyes, but will they want me to? But all
those mean words that pulled my world. Don't make me feel like less than anymore, because I know that I love so deep. Not all stuff that goes in that big open door, but all of us are beautiful. The moment we are born, comes on two sides, the main suitor.
Away from your family. But when I was, you know, thinking about
what I could do as a, you know, a white girl, a country singer, like, and on social media, I was like, I'll just post a stupid black square. Like, what does that do for anybody? So I've spent the past, you know, a few weeks trying to further educate myself on, you know, what, like, there's so many things we're not taught in history books. I mean, don't even get me started. Just go to my Twitter, you'll see my feelings and everything. But this song feels like how I think that we're reaching this peak where things are coming to a head, and it's not that like things are getting worse, they've kind of been this way. It's just people are starting to really be able to be like, yeah, we have a problem in our society with this. So this sort of matches that righteous anger, I think, that like hopefully all of us are feeling about the treatment of black people in America. So it's not what I wrote the song about, but it certainly feels right. So this one's called Angry Butterfly.
Nerve to go retrograde in this economy. I just can't believe it.
No,
This is like sisterhood of the traveling guitars. It's actually like a really beautiful example of how we help each other.
Right?
Just barely made it. She does these really great one girl covers on her Instagram page where she'll play like all five instruments and edit herself together. It's pure sorcery. And you can follow her at Mia Morris Music. But this is my favorite part where you guys all get to go, but like, Mia, you have a birthday coming up. Tell them how old you're turning.
I'm
going
to turn 16.
I want to be you when I grow up, and I don't know how that logistically works, but I want that. You're going to hear more from me later, but pay one more big round of applause.
Okay, Mia, we're going to be halfway home. Okay, well, like I said, I'm from Canada. There's a thing called Canadian Country Music Awards. Long story, very short. I got to do this program where I had a mentor. Didn't know who I would be mentored by. And it just so happened to be this artist named Jess Moskaluk. And I was very nervous because I had just like a cold call, like waiting on a call, kind of like Zoom meetings. You know, you're just waiting there and I'm like, hi. And they're like, oh my God. And then they tell you. And I was a little bit nervous. But fast forward 4 years, 3 years. We wrote together, we write for her album and stuff, and the song, I don't know where it is this week, but last week we were number 4 in Australia, and we were number 27 in Canada, so, this one's called Halfway Home.
I'm gonna make it.
So I'm going to play this one. We'll see how it goes. I wrote it during quarantine with my friend SJ McDonald. Yeah, you know her. She's cool. This one, it like sounds like it was inspired by quarantine, but actually it was inspired by last summer. I bought this kiddie pool and put it in my backyard and played music and like would just lay outside in my backyard because I was like, I don't know where a pool is and this is cool, I can listen to my own music. So this one's called Backyard Beach and I hope you like it.
Stacy,
right? And how her life was after dealing with the drama between her boyfriends always noticing her mom, right? And so it's basically just a sequel to Stacey's Mom. Something that's kind of cool about the actual recording of this song is that there was a video of me doing some session work on Facebook, and the guitar player for Fountains of Wayne commented on it, Jody Porter. And so I was like, hey, man, you know, you should like play a solo on this song that I wrote. That'd be freaking rad. And he did. So we did. Yeah. Anyway, this is called Stacey's Song. Her view on life all changed in middle school. She won't buy a fancy car or swimming.
Suffragettes for having all of us coming. And yeah, they're just freaking songs. And this song is called Mood. I hope you guys like it.
Stab someone with scissors.
using obviously not his arms, and they use his feet.
The thing is, that phases a lot of people, but it really doesn't phase me at all. Like, I feel like I've seen it all. And so,
I'm from Maine, which people call Florida the North.
Oh, okay. You got it. So I was like, get me out of Florida. Like, I want to go someplace else. And then I, as soon as I moved away, I was like, damn, I really miss home. And I really miss the people, and I really miss my family, and I really miss all of the reasons I maybe want to leave in the first place. And I feel like I forgave all of those reasons, or those things that made me want to leave in the first place. And I feel like that happens to a lot of people, that, you know, as you grow older, you get to forgive some of those things that made you want to leave as a child. So that's kind of what inspired the song. It's called Take Me Home. But now I feel like, especially with all of these times, you really, really appreciate, one, having a home, but two, you know, being able to go to those people who make it feel like home. So this song is Take Me Home.
Cat skulls, so I think that's important.
It's a hell cat.
collection. So they're not only cats, but they're like freaky cats.
Cool. Okay. Guys, I thought it was funny about Dan, actually not. Okay. So this is another song off of my album, and yesterday was Father's Day. Shout out to the dads. But this is not about that. It's a so Father's Day is such a great holiday because if you're a great dad, you deserve a holiday. You deserve ties and hugs from kids and strippers. But there's a lot of people who have strained relationships with their fathers, or they don't have them, and they haven't seen them in a long time. There's so many different things, and so Father's Day comes around, and I'm just like, oh. And since releasing my album and documenting all of that on my record, I started working on a relationship with my dad, which has been really great. But I wrote this song about growing up, being raised by a single mom who did double duty. And there's a line about Father's Day in here, so if anybody relates, I'm terribly sorry, but you can find just as much love in one parent as you can in two. And I'm very lucky to have had a mom who cared about me that much, and this is called Big Houses.
Thank you.
memories, and that's just like,
you know, places, I don't know. You ever hear a breakup song and you can be so happy and it just wrecks your world? And that's what I love about music, you know? I'm like, why do we do this to ourselves when we write all these songs that make us cry? And then we play them, and then you can't hit a note because you're crying. You're like, I did this to myself.
I feel very thankful that I have music because, you know, sometimes it does suck being a songwriter in the sense of we make money of kind of going through hell. Like I was writing, you know, about stuff that's like, you have to be very vulnerable and people get to judge you and be like, I don't, so on and so forth. But at the same time, I'm very thankful that I can get what I have to say out on paper, happy or sad. That was a great song. Yeah, it was great. I was gonna do a song that's already out on Spotify, but I think I'm gonna do a song that I'm about to release. It's coming out on July 15th. I can't change it, it's already in the little download thing. It's called Clear to Me. Like crying, so now I have to drink some water because I'm not trying to make it.
I literally told y'all that many girls are gonna cry tonight, and that's what you got. So it's just like there's always a lot of estrogen in this room, but there's like so much more tonight.
I really didn't know that. Well, this one's happy, I promise. This is probably, I don't even think I've played this live. Maybe I have on the live stream. But before I talk about it, I just want to say thank you, listening, obviously, to everyone that's on Suffragettes. It's so nice to meet you. I haven't played with you. I haven't played with Julie and Aaron. It's really great to hear you live. You're great over the live stream, but holy crap, I wasn't ready for that.
Oh,
great. It's, I'm very happy you moved to town. This is awesome.
Oh, yes, me too.
The song's called Clear to Me, and like everyone, we go through our things, and life is just real foggy, and you're like, wow. And then all of a sudden, it's like you wake up, and everything's just, someone took the Windex on your life, and you're like, cool, this is nice, I like this. And, you know, not to go all, you know, Jesus-y on anyone, but I didn't grow up with God in my life, and I didn't grow up with it being in my household, and I'm very lucky that I found it on my own, and my own pace, and this is kind of a song that's like about that. And also meeting someone that's like nice to me.
What a concept.
What a concept. You be with someone that treats you good. Wow. Guys included. Girls are crazy. I'm sorry. I apologize for anyone. But if you know that is coming to you as well. So help clearly. My name's Libby Jean.
No doubt. Just don't
two girls.
Personally, one of my favorite songs of all time. So, if you guys know it, go for it.